Hello everyone, we're back with Dark Souls. At least hopefully, this is an experimental recording wherein I am trying to make sure that not only are my audio levels all adjusted correctly where they need to be, but also that there is audio at all coming from the daggone video game. As it appears there is, I'm looking at some green bars flickering back and forth. I'm gonna get a little bit inside baseball here, but it has been about a month since I've recorded anything at all. And that is because a little device that allows me to take the video and audio that's coming from my PlayStation to my TV and put it onto my computer, that device crapped out on me. It's called an Elgato, and it is a very handy tool. However, if it stops capturing game audio, you cannot hear all of the little musical stings, the slashes and swipes, the grunts of pain, and the triumphant defeated the boss fanfare that occurs every time I do so. And so that was getting me down. I worked with Elgato's IT and help desk for literally a month trying to figure that out, and lo and behold, the solution was to get a new Elgato. So that finally came in today, and let me tell you, I'm thankful. There's a chance that if this current recording even makes it to YouTube, it'll be coming out the week of Thanksgiving. So, I think thankfulness will be our theme. Just as I'm thankful, you, my lovely viewing audience, can be thankful that you get to watch me be incredibly lucky at Source 3. What a treat for you. In the spirit of being rusty, we're just going to go ahead and tackle the next boss. It is the one we have been aiming for throughout most of our time here in Irithyll Valley. The good pontiff himself, Suliban, who's been instrumental in getting Aldrich to do what Aldrich gonna do. I have also not played Dark Souls 3 in about a month. So all of the muscle memory and the pathing and the hype that I've been experiencing to get to our buddy Suliban has decayed by the slow passage of time. Not unlike a microcosm of the Dark Souls universe. Entropy had taken hold of my gameplay and did not want to let go. I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. In the interest of not beating my head up against the wall, we're gonna enlist a little bit of help. Not that one. Why don't we get our good buddy Henri? Seems plot significant and fitting, as he is also tracking Grim Aldrich. Have him fight a bit of the architect of some of Aldrich's doings lately. Can see some other summon signs out here from some helpful players. Try rolling. You know what? Good. That's a good message. Because, I still live on here. Doesn't seem to know what's standing there. That is the good Pontiff Sullivan, who is really not all that good. Take a look at his soul, the shape of his soul. Pontiff Sullivan of Irithyll imprisoned a god of the old royalty in the abandoned cathedral to be fed to the devourer. Now that is quite a sentence. Lore-wise. So we know who the Devourer is, rather. That is Aldrich, the one we've been tracking. Now the old god in the cathedral is a bit of a mystery at this point, but we shall see. Perhaps not quite in this setting, but we shall see very soon who that could be. I'm gonna take a look at what his soul can give us, weapon-wise.
Aha, that's so.
Great Sword of Judgment. Pretty good Great Sword. And the Profane Great Sword, which I think is an even better Great Sword. But alas.
Now.
Not the build we're going for. We're gonna be disrespectful. And immediately consume his soul. it wasn't clear, so the bomb being from Irithyll.
Very well, then Tuckhaken.
He is also the one who sent out the Outrider Knights. The good old Vort of the Boreal Valley. And the other Outrider Knights that we encountered along the way. He is the architect of their
farewell, Ashen, may the flame.
They're sending out. I need a few more souls here. I think I can eke another level out.
Welcome.
Now we'll say, actually, our business is not yet concluded in the Earthville. Obviously, we haven't left it yet, but
farewell, Ashen.
There's actually more, I believe, to be done, and I may not spend a ton of time on this, because I don't want to waste. I may have missed it, actually, by defeating Suliban, but we've met Cirrus of the Dark Moon Covenant. He said there wasn't a whole lot to be gained from us fraternizing. But I believe there is a bit of a side quest for her that can be accomplished. Yes, okay. Yeah, Cirrus of the Sunless Realms. We're gonna cooperate with her. And I'm gonna tell you right now, I have never done this before. This is new info to me. So a bit like Dark Souls 1, where we went to another world to confront Lautrec, defending our Firekeeper, we're entering another world to help Cirrus. She's got some business. Great news.
For your kind assistance. Blessing of the moon upon your journey.
You too, Cirrus. You too. I enjoyed our encounter. I like your shiny purple sword. So yeah, we have at least started another character quest line. And once again, I've never done that before, so I actually don't know what else to do. Get the impression she might be showing up at Firelink. I'm gonna head back there for now. See if we can chat about it. Yeah, there she is.
I have not thanked you for your generous rescue. That dark spirit was one of Rosaria's fingers. Vile, bastard offspring who lurk in the darkness. My sworn enemies. Fearsome invaders, to say the least. I would not have made it alone. You have my deepest gratitude.
A blessed mailbreaker in the Silvercat ring.
If you require help on your travels, I offer you my sign.
Look at that.
Blessing of the moon upon your journey.
And to thee as well. Wow. I never knew where to get the silver cat ring before now. Prevents damage from falling. In the Age of Gods, or possibly just falling it, an old cat was set to speak a human tongue with the voice of an old woman in the form of a fanciful immortal. Huh. Well, there we have it. We are learning together today. Huh. So I don't know if there's more to do with Cirrus. I think there might be. But I'm not about to pause the recording to find out right now. But that is neat. That is neat and cool. Once again, just something I've never done before. So this is a doubly exciting episode. We are back after far too long away. doing something entirely new even to me. But yeah, we have defeated Pontiff Sullivan, but unfortunately have not quite put an end to his designs. And for that we'll need to continue onward. There's actually a bit of cut content from this game that had to do with Sullivan. Primarily just, okay, more things he was going to be dastardly at. Okay, wow, that took way too long. You can never get both of those unless you have a really big weapon. So I'll come back for the other lizard later. But yeah, there is definitely some unused stuff when it comes to Sullivan. I think he may have originally been meant to, He may have originally been the ultimate antagonist of this game, actually. There's just a lot going on with the doings of the other great lords that has something, a lot, to do with him. I ran out here a little prematurely. This giant graveyard, as it were. And I say prematurely because I forgot about the Drang Boys. Look at them RP walking over to me. Can RP walk over to you? No. Keep coming. I know you want me. Yeah, these guys, come on, they like to rubber band a little bit, back to their starting positions. But, once you get them going, okay. And I've been online, been murdered by another player. Okay. This is an actual online invasion. Hello, Dorian. You're alive. And you're dead. I'm pretty sure, because of the latency with my stabs, that was actually a dude online. So, Dorian, you've been immortalized on the internet. I respect the hustle. I really do. I honestly never expect or even make much of an effort to win online duels. But here we are. We did it. It's all coming back to me, everyone. Take the boy away from the Dark Souls. Never take the Dark Souls out of war. Yeah, that giant got up. A few of them do. I tend not to worry about it. Also, that was a good message. This is an illusory wall leading to a ladder that goes way, way down. And I'm not going down there yet. We will return in Marvel's Avengers 17. We'll return there at a later time when I feel a little better equipped to tackle what is down there. Because for now I don't. I definitely don't. But, got some old friends here. You may recall, I played Dark Souls 1 yet again, that these silver knights like to arch. Arch they do. And sometimes they fall. And that's okay too. That guy's not dead. I know that. Oh, I gotta heal. I know how much these guys messed me up earlier. See, I'm forgetting things. Because it's been too long. Too long. Can you feel it? Too long. Can you feel it? I'm gonna stop singing before I get copyright struck. Oh yeah, there's another set of ashes down here too. I'm gonna read those ashes. The Easterner. From an armor merchant from an eastern land. This merchant, the captain of a clan of hunters, was fascinated with weaponry. Which that too, I believe, is a Dark Souls 1 reference. Oh, I got bamboozled. Some arrows, though. Yeah, I forgot he was there. Let's see here. We got Dos Mas. Get rid of these fire bombs. We have some kukri. No, no. Come on. Walk on. What happened? Bad. Okay. I'm gonna get magic weapon up again. Won't lie, there was a brief moment where I forgot I had that. Oh boy. We got spear time now.
Oh, I knew it.
Cocky. I did what Han Solo didn't want me to do. I got cocky, kid. Good news. I believe I can get this other crystal lizard. I can run. Awesome. And, more good news, I won't have to deal with any invaders, because my ember be gone. I believe that's how it works in this game. So sorry, Dorian. Our only encounter. Firebenders here in a bit, but I would like to get my souls back. It's difficult to decide whether I just want a beeline, because they will continue shooting arrows at me. You know what? 25,000 is an okay amount. Well, that worked all right. We seem to be in a somewhat familiar setting now. Visions of attacking. Now, why would someone attack a statue of the great Lord Gwyn? Well, looky here. Time for princess, indeed. Anybody's nostalgia bone quivering right now? Be forgiven if they were. Ooh, the brass set. That is a good set, if we recall. And a set that did have some connection with a room that looks suspiciously like this. It's empty for now. There may yet be something on the other side to discover. This is not a trap. Reversal ring. Pretty sure that gives male characteristics to female characters, and vice versa if you wear it. I've never actually been sure what that means, because I think most of the gestures and such are pretty similar. I don't know if it changes your voice and things like that too. Never really been super interested in it. But yeah, this room is certainly a throwback. And possibly an indication of where we might be heading next. It is quite a contraption. Staircase made from carved stone. Huh. I realize I'm probably dragging this out too long. For those of you who watched my Dark Souls 1 playthrough, where we were having maybe already apparent, or if you have already played Dark Souls 1 before, quite likely. We have reached the biggest Dark Souls 1 reference of all time. Man, Orlando, everyone. Something just died. I don't know what. Yeah. Here in the Boreal Valley, in Irithyll, we actually have, right smack up against it, the dwelling place of the old gods. Looks a bit mustier than it used to. Someone keeps dying. They keep getting souls. Never thou worry. Silver Knights are still running around. We need Silver Knights too. Be annoying. That is neat. will say this is actually a great mid-game farming spot. If you're looking for some extra souls, just come up here, blast these knights over and over again. Interesting. And acquire quite a bit of souls while doing it. I saw that summon sign there. I'm not going to ignore it, I don't think. For now. We're going to experience some sadness. Again, if you're familiar with the previous iteration of Anor-Londo, you'll know that this peaceable giant was a good friend and blacksmith, and a welcome sight after everything you go through to get to him. But unfortunately, he has passed away at this point. We're actually quite literally following the steps that Aldrich took into Anor-Londo when he arrived. You can see the staircase here is covered in gunk. And I don't think it is a stretch to say that Aldrich probably killed the good giant on the way in. So rip in peace, brother. Has also been overrun by the Eldritch faithful. Remember them from the Cathedral of the Deep. Now I will show you something very nice. Is off this balcony here. You can see there is a slime sitting there. Not there by accident. I'm just going to get him away from it for now. Because this chest has another Estus shard. Oh. And we activated the big boy. Chris's big boy is right over here. Turning this crank, though, gets an invincibility thing in case it sees us. We opened a door and we got an Estus shard. Oh boy. There's actually another one of those beasts in the Cathedral of the Deep. I totally skipped because I did not want to deal with him back when I was at that level. Not sure I want to deal with him now. It would behoove me, if I want it to be useful. Hopefully we can get by these ceiling if we have too much. Acid. excuse me. Saw your door was open. Just wanted to let you know. Got any grim amalgamations of limbs and bone? Huh. You can leave with the people, just so you know. Everything about this piece is just cursed. Including the map. And yeah, I'm pretty sure everything else about him. Luckily, he's a one-and-done kind of guy. Let's see what Aldrich's Ruby says. A malformed ring left by Aldrich seems deep. Recovers HP from critical attacks. Aldrich, infamous for his appetite for flesh, apparently had the desire to share with others his joy of imbibing the final shudders of life while luxuriating in his victim's screams. Neat. Going to backtrack a little bit back to the Sullivan bonfire just to kind of thoroughly explore the courtyard that we just fought through. Because as I said, there was another path that we could follow to deal with the flame spurters. So I believe that putting over here. Yes. Lead us up. Now we can unlock this elevator. You recall the pontiff stood on the switch for this during the fight. But yeah, we now have a bit of a shortcut to the courtyard area. And I believe I've kind of missed the opportunity to easily do another one. May have to go back past all the archers again to unlock it. But while we're in the rafters here, we're gonna harass another one of these guys. Get a simple gem. How about that dark, eh? And there is another chest with a bunch of messages leading up to it. Which you know means nothing at all in these games. About grab tracking. A lot of enemy grab animations are Put it quite simply, bullshit. But I think it is still something in this game's favor to say that you can very easily tell when something probably shouldn't have happened the way that it did, simply because so many enemy interactions and hits actually do come off pretty well. Now I need to be sure not to... Okay. Lost souls. Gonna give this another try. Yeah, dodging to the side is tough because he will track you with that grab. Just get away from him. It's a little easier. Ooh, idiot fight. There we go. Unfortunately, he doesn't really give us anything we're going to need. But that is a little bit of the raptors up here. I did say we were going to deal with these guys. These guys apart. Didn't have a lot of trouble with him. Trouble comes when they bunch up. Earlier. It's okay. Really got the power at me no longer. Super necessary for the quest. Cleared a bit of that up. Actually, I'm just gonna bone out real quick. I think I'm gonna head back to Firelink, take care of these souls that I've received. Level up a couple times.
Welcome home, speak then. Very well, then take Nar.
Clean 35. Manifestation. Bump that up to 16. Elucidated by fire.
Farewell, Ashen One. May the.
Let's see if I can get 22,000. Unlikely. Well, maybe likely. Fairly likely. And let's see. Might be nice to get a little bit more endurance too.
Farewell, I may the.
We're gonna grab ourselves another Estus flask.
Ah, tis good to what needs me.
Oh, that's right. Let me get this real quick.
Perfect.
Never looked at our buddy Giant's coal. It was said that the giant blacksmith of Anorondo was once the blacksmith of the gods. Give to the blacksmith in the shrine to allow the use of gems for lightning, simple, and chaos infusion.
Ah, tis what need.
We'll do that.
My, my. The coal of that peaceable giant. Seems like ages passed. I imagine his passing was long ago. I miss the old bugger, I do. My thanks. I'll be sure this coal is put to good use. I'll be smithing weapons never afore seen by the likes of ye. It's but a small service to pay my humble respects.
Good man. So yeah, we actually have quite a few infusions available to us now. Just a matter of getting the gems for them. I do have a shark gem. Need to make sure that my weapon setup would be conducive to using a gem. I don't want to waste anything before I would actually need it. I think the shark gem would increase my damage output overall. A little bit less physical, but I'd get more from my dexterity here. Oh, I'll probably take a look at that out of recording mode.
Pretty, I don't.
Because for now, I think I might actually end it here. This was intended just to be a quick experiment to make sure that audio was balanced correctly. And you know what? I still have no idea if that's true. But we're back. I got excited. I wanted to dark some souls. Well, at least a brass helmet, not the brass set. But yeah. We uncovered a little bit, defeated Pontiff Solibon, and found our next destination, which is actually quite a familiar one. So when we return, we're going to trek back through Anorondo, see how things have been in the intervening centuries, perhaps millennia. So yeah, thank you all for your support. I am excited to be back. It's probably not going to look like I was gone, given my upload schedule, but for me, it is quite a thing. And I'm loving it. So yeah, appreciate your time, and I'll catch you in the next one.